guys, welcome back to my channel. I am doing a little bit of pre-filming because I really want to do Vlogmas this year. It'll be my first time and I don't think I've uploaded every day in a hot second. I used to upload every day back in the day, like 4 or 5 years ago, but it was not sustainable. And I don't know, I just feel like Vlogmas is kind of fun and it is supposed to be a time where I believe I've heard people say that YouTube kind of like increases your AdSense. So I thought, let me try and capitalize on that. Like, why not? I'm gonna be really honest with you guys. Like, why not? I thought I'd be curious to do so because, you know, my AdSense is getting a little bit better because my channel is growing like a tiny bit. So I'm interested. It's like a social experiment. I love to like try things on YouTube and see like how it pans out. So curious to see if there's a difference in my AdSense in December. I don't know. I hope you guys don't mind me saying that. I just want to be transparent and honest with you guys. So I'm going to attempt to upload every day in December. God knows if that's going to work out or not, but I am pre-filming. So this is going to be a pre-film video. And basically I had the idea of going back to my favorites from 2018. So I did film a favorites video in 2018, just kind of like a year end favorites. And you guys know I get really anxious about filming favorites videos just because I always feel like it's a lot of like pressure to narrow things down. If you've been on my channel before and you've watched one of my videos talking about like current favorites or like monthly favorites, you guys know how much it like makes me like cringe a little bit. But I did film a 2018 favorites and I went through the video, wrote down everything I talked about, and I thought it would be fun to look back at what were my favorite products in 2018. Are they still favorites? Do they still live in my collection or have they long been forgotten? It was so fun to watch 2018 Karen talk about what her favorite products from the year was, and I definitely will be doing a 2019 favorites as well. I feel like I've discovered some stellar products in the year 2019, so we definitely want to forever archive that in our YouTube history, so when it comes to December 2020, I can film the same kind of video, like duh. So anyway, without further blabbering, let's get into it. So the first thing I talked about in my 2018 favorites is the Natasha Denona Duo Glow in the shade Alba. Oh my gosh, this product still lives in my collection. It is still one of my favorite blush highlighter, like hybrid kind of products, and I've definitely accumulated more peachy glowy blushes, but this one is just kind of the OG glowy blush in my collection. I'm really hoping Natasha Denona adds more singles to that line. I would love to see her do more shades because she's only had two, and I know my friend Angelica raves about the pink shade. Can't remember what that one is called, but she loves the pink one. I don't think I'll personally pick up the pink shade because I don't really like pink blushes on me, but I know Angie really, really wants to pick up Alba. So, you know, it's recommended by the both of us. We've each tried each of the shades and I really still like Alba and I don't see myself getting rid of it anytime soon. The next product I mentioned is the Kevin Aucoin Neo Blush in the shade Sunset. This one is also still a favorite of mine. I am a sucker for a good peachy blush and this one is just like such a perfect, beautiful blush. It looks like I've been outside and it gives me this amazing flush. So I really, really like that blush and again, still in my collection. The next thing I talked about is my highlighter fave from 2018, which was the Amorizzi collab highlighter with Anastasia Beverly Hills. I recently filmed a highlighter declutter, not sure if it's up yet, but I definitely kept my ABH highlighter. It's such a good one. I love the formula. I know so many people are begging for Anastasia to come out with more shades in that particular formula, and I couldn't agree more. I think it is one of the best highlighters of all time, and I'm so glad I picked one up because I was definitely not planning on it. I was like, oh, I have so many of those shades, I don't need it, but I'm so, so glad that I did end up picking it up so that I have it, because now every time it restocks, it like sells out, and it was a limited edition product, so people like get into a panic when they relaunch it. So the next thing I talked about is the Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette. And honestly, I haven't really used that palette too much this year at all. And they did come out with a part 2, which I picked up. And I haven't really used part two either, so you won't be seeing it in my 2019 favorites. But I think in 2020, I'm gonna make more of an effort to try out the palette as well as go back to the first one and, you know, really work with the formulas and see if it's something I want to continue keeping in my collection in the years to come. The next thing I talked about is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finishing Powder in the shade 2, and I actually did hit pan on that powder. I have kind of put it in my drawer again because I don't want to like finish it up in a hurry, and I have a lot of loose setting powders to get through, so I kind of only pull it out for really special occasions or if I'm not in the mood to deal with a loose setting powder. But I do still really enjoy that product, and I think I will repurchase it when I pan it. But for now, I'm happy with the one I have, and I use it, you know, when the occasion calls for it. It is a good product, and I'm definitely happy that I tried it and I own it. The next products are the Pat McGrath lip glosses as well as her sheer balms. That's actually the lip combo I'm wearing today. I had kind of forgotten about the lip balms. I was definitely wearing the glosses in the summertime paired with the ColourPop blotted lips because I love to wear the blotted lips with a juicy gloss on top. And so when I rewatched my 2018 favorites, it reminded me how much I really like those balms, and I have such chapped lips right now because the seasons are changing and it's getting really cold here that I've been using them now again nonstop, and I'm reminded why I like that formula. And so that's what I have on my lips. I have the Flesh Balm as well as the Flesh 3 lip gloss. Such a good shade from Pat McGrath, and it's just perfect for the holiday time. I feel like this is such a holiday inspired look that I have on, and I did film this look, so if you guys are interested, definitely search on my channel. This is the Natasha Denona Star Palette eyeshadow look, so you guys should be able to find that pretty quick. And then another liquid lip formula, or another lip formula I had mentioned in my 2018 favorites, were the Morphe liquid lips in the shade True Story and Peanut. And honestly, these are still my favorite nudes. I haven't found anything that has piqued my interest as much as these two shades have. And anytime I'm wearing True Story in a video, I get comments. Anytime I'm wearing it on Instagram, I get comments, people asking me what the shade is, because it is the perfect liquid lipstick for tan girls. And Morphe did come out with a beautiful lip set for the holidays, and I think it's like $30 and you get 3 liquid lips and 3 glosses, and it includes some of my favorite nudes. So if you haven't picked that up yet and it is still available, definitely do consider taking a look at that because it's amazing. So the next thing I mentioned in my 2018 favorites is the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in the shade Karma. Now I still have Karma, but I have not worn it since, I think. It's just kind of living in my weird lipstick shades drawer, and I haven't really whipped it out and, you know, used it. But again, I think it's going to be something that I'm going to see in 2020 if I use it, or otherwise I'm just going to get rid of it from my collection. But it's definitely a fun, unique shade. I'm definitely going to be more selective the end of this year as well as next year on liquid lipsticks, because I also did film a lipstick declutter and I decluttered close to 100 and something lipsticks. So I have a collection now that I'm very happy with. I swatched each one and I don't really feel the need to add more to my collection. So I'm very happy with everything I have currently, and I don't see myself adding more to my liquid lipstick or just gloss or anything like that. I don't see myself adding to it. The next thing I talked about were all palettes. So I had a lot of palette favorites in 2018, and oh my gosh, watching the video, I was like, oh, that was a good palette. Yeah, like, you know, it's been really fun. So the first palette I mentioned was a Pat McGrath Labs Bronze Seduction palette. This is Mothership 6, I believe, or 5? Mothership 5. And it was the beautiful reds and the bronzy tones, and it was honestly the most everyday palette she had launched to date, because all the other ones had more playful color stories, blues, greens, things like that, whereas this one was more neutral. Since then, she's come out with Midnight Sun, which definitely is the most wearable of her palettes. When I first got Midnight Sun, I didn't love it, and now that I've used it a few more times and played with some of the other shades, I do realize the value of that palette, so I'm really, really thankful, because I was a little bit annoyed that I'd spent that money, but I've come around to it. But the Bronze Seduction, oh, such a great palette for the holiday time. I kind of feel like I should whip it out and do a look with that palette, so let me know if you want to see that. But such a gorgeous palette, such beautiful shades. Oh, I love it so much. The other palette I had mentioned was the Dose of Colors I Love Sara Yee palette. Now, that palette definitely still lives in my collection, but I have not picked it up at all in 2019, which is kind of sad because it is a stunning palette and it's a small palette. And I think it's a great palette for travel and things like that, but I just didn't reach for it at all this year. So definitely good to be reminded that I should pick it up and see if it's something that I should continue to hold on to in my collection. And then also the Dose of Colors Friendcation palette, same thing, great palette, great formula, great shades, just a beautiful palette overall, like 10 out of 10. One of my favorite palettes, and I haven't used it at all because I've been so busy using newer products, but I am so glad that I did try it in 2018. So the next palette I talked about was the ColourPop Good Sport palette. Now this palette is definitely everyone's, like one of everyone's favorite ColourPop palettes. I see it all the time in the ranking videos. I know Angelica gave it the highest ranking when she ranked all her ColourPop palettes, and honestly I could agree with her very much. I haven't used it again in a while, so that's one of those palettes too that if I have the time, I would love to pull out and play with it again because I think it's such a good color story. It's a great fall palette. It's got some great burgundy shades, golds, like stuff that you can, you know, mix and match and make some amazing holiday eye looks. So I want to play with it again, but yeah, that's definitely one of my favorite ColourPop palettes, and I don't think ColourPop launched anything in 2019 that can top that palette for me yet. Okay, the next thing that I mentioned was the Melt Cosmetics Smoke Sessions. Again, this palette is still my favorite Melt Cosmetics palette. They came out with two palettes this year in 2019, and I didn't pick up either of them. If there's anything else they launched, I don't remember. I just remember the Radioactive and that other one that's like the, is it called the Inferno or so? I don't remember what it's called, but it's the one they launched with Sephora. It's like the Step palette. And so I haven't really seen anything I love from Melt this year. The Smoke Sessions palette is honestly so beautiful. It's one of my favorite green palettes, and they just launched for holiday. They did that, those two palettes for, I can't remember what that collection is called, but it's like a reference to Mexican culture and things like that. So I'm very excited to get my hands on it and play with it. But so far, the Smoke Session palette by Melt is like my number one favorite palette from Melt Cosmetics. So the next palette I mentioned in my 2018 favorites was the Huda Nu Nudes palette. Now, I haven't, again, used that palette really this year either. Or maybe I did. I might have used it on some of my friends for makeup looks that I did for them. But I haven't really gone back to it personally. And I know Alter Ego came out with a palette called the Daydream palette, which is supposed to be a dupe for the new nudes by Huda as well. So I have both of those palettes, and I still know there's a special place for the new nudes in my collection, because if I ever need to do something subtle or like Eastery or just like springy or neutral or like bridal, I can definitely go back to that palette. And so I'm so glad that it is in my collection. I don't see myself decluttering it anytime soon. The next palette I mentioned in my favorites was the Gimme Glow Cosmetics Christmas Morning palette, and I love that palette. It is one of the indie brands in this video. I, you know, didn't really talk about much of the other indie brands, and I just wanted to give Gimme Glow a shout out because their shimmer formula is amazing. They're actually gonna relaunch that palette this holiday season. So if you are wondering if you should get it, I did film a review of that palette on my channel like the beginning of this year or like end of last year. So just search Christmas Morning Palette on my channel and you will be able to find my review. If I remember, I'll try and link it or pin it in the comments section so you guys can watch it, because I know a lot of you are kind of eyeing that palette if it does release from Give Me Glow this year. And I would still recommend it. I am not gonna get rid of it. It's one of my prized possessions in my makeup collection. Okay, we're getting close to the end here. The next palette I mentioned in my 2018 favorites is the Natasha Denona Gold Palette. Now, I love the gold palette so, so much. I think I've convinced quite a few people to buy it, and I always get so excited when I see people purchasing the gold palette because I just think it's so good. It was definitely my favorite Natasha Denona palette before she launched the Metropolis palette. I just think it's such a fun palette. You can use it every day, you can glam with it, you can just do a neutral eye look. Like, it's such a perfect palette, and it's got so many fun textures and so many ways that you can play with it and do so many different things. So I really love it for that, and it's definitely not going anywhere. I will continue to love and treasure that palette as well. And then last, but certainly not least, is the Juvia's Place Tribe Palette. This is such a great green palette as well. You guys know I love wearing green on my eyeballs. I know it's not everyone's favorite color or everyone's cup of tea, but I was so happy when brands started coming out with green eyeshadow palettes, because green was such a hard color to find in palettes. Like, it was one of those shades that was just haphazardly thrown into every neutral palette every once in a while. But at the end of 2018 and the beginning of 2019, I feel like so many brands were just doing singular green themed palettes, which really just spoke to me on a deep personal level. I was so happy about that. And yeah, I just love the Juvia's Place palette so, so much. It's definitely my favorite Juvia's Place palette. Nothing that they've come out with in 2019 beats the Tribe palette in my opinion, and I really, really want to do another eyeshadow look with that palette as well, because I think it's absolutely stunning. Okay guys, so that is everything for going back and looking at my 2018 favorites video. Let me know what you guys think of this video, and if I mentioned some of your favorites or if I didn't, definitely leave those down in the comments. Are you guys still loving things that you've had in your collection for over a year, or have you moved on to bigger and better? I'm always curious to know and talk to you guys, so I will hear from you down in the comments. Just want to say thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope you guys are having a wonderful holiday season, and I will see you in my next video soon. Bye guys!